One area where Affinity Photo struggles to compete with Photoshop is luminosity masking. A few years ago, I released this video explaining how to create luminosity masks in Affinity Photo just as you might in Photoshop. The only problem with that approach is that the processing is complicated. You see, Photoshop users have an advantage when it comes to luminosity masking. They can use third-party extensions that make the process much easier, and unfortunately, these don't yet work in Affinity Photo. That's why I've been thinking hard and I've come up with a simple method to produce luminosity masks in Affinity. Not only that, but this new method also allows you to create luminosity masks interactively. Let's look at how using this landscape image. The first thing I need to do is produce a black and white version of the image to work with. I'll just add a black and white adjustment layer using the icon at the bottom of the Layer Studio panel. The next step is to add three curves adjustment layers, again using the icon at the bottom of the Layer Studio panel. Then I'll rename these new curve layers to be lights, darks, and midtones. We'll be using these to create our luminosity masks. Finally, I'll just group all four layers together and call these luminosity masks. Having the layers in a single group like this keeps them separate from our other adjustments. Now for the clever part, which is to use our curves layers to create the luminosity masks. We'll start with the lights curve first, which we'll use to target the lighter tones of the image. The first point I'm going to add to the curve is in the center. I'll then drag that down so that it's on the lower line of the grid. The second point I want to add is where the curve crosses the upper grid line. I can then drag that point up until it meets the diagonal red line. Notice that the black and white image is now very dark except for the lightest areas of the image. We can therefore use this to create a mask targeting the lightest areas. Let's turn that off now so that I can show you how to adjust the darks curve. This time we want to make the darkest areas of the image appear white and the lightest areas appear black. The way to do this with a curve is to reverse the direction of the curve line. By moving the black point to the top left of the grid and the white point to the bottom right, it produces a negative of our image. Now I can repeat what I did for the lights curve. I'll click on the center point and drag that down to meet the lower grid line. Then I'll add another point where the curve crosses the upper grid line before dragging that up. Now we have an image that we could use to create a mask targeting the darkest areas. Let's turn that off and adjust our third curve to target the midtones of the image. First, I'll move the white point of the curve down to the bottom so that the image appears black. Now I can add a point in the center of the curve line and drag that up to the top. Then I'll add a point on the left side of the curve and drag it in towards the center. After that, I'll repeat the process on the right side of the curve. Now we've created everything we need to produce luminosity masks to target different tones in the image. Now let me show you an example of how we can use these curves, and then I'll show you some ways to refine the selection process. Let's start with an adjustment to lighten the shadows in this image. I'm going to do this by adding a new empty layer and changing the blending mode to overlay. What this means is that when I paint onto the layer using white paint, it will lighten those areas of the image. Of course, what I don't want to do is paint on the lightest areas to make those lighter still, which is where the dark's luminosity mask comes in. To use it, I need to make only the dark curve visible. Now, if we look at the channels window, we can see a composite red, green, and blue channel. When I right-click on one of these channels, I can convert it to a selection by choosing the Load to Pixel selection option. Now you can see the marching ants, indicating there's an active selection. At this point, you can hide the luminosity mask group in the Layer Studio panel. The next step is best done without the marching ants being visible, so I'll hide them using the Show option in the View menu. Now I can paint using white onto my layer in the areas where I want to lighten the shadows. A tip when you're doing this though is to have the layer opacity set at about 70%. This allows you to increase or reduce the strength of the effect using the opacity slider. The image is now looking much better, but it's left it looking a little flat because there isn't a true black. Let's fix this by adding a levels adjustment layer. Notice that the new adjustment is created with a layer mask produced from our active selection. Now I can adjust the image whilst only affecting the darkest areas. Let's clear the dark selection now by pressing Command and D on your keyboard. If you're using a Windows PC, that's Control and D. We'll now go back to our Luminosity Mask group, and this time we'll load a Lights Mask to work with. The process is the same as before, where I make only the lights curve visible. I can then right click on one of the composite channels and choose the Load to Pixel selection option. This time we don't see the marching ants, because if you remember, I chose to hide them in the View menu. Let's then hide the Luminosity Mask group so we can work on the image. If I add a Levels adjustment layer again, it creates a mask from the active selection. Having done that, I can adjust the highlights in the image using the Levels adjustment sliders. So far we've used our Luminosity Mask created from our curves without changing them. But we can also manipulate these curves to better target specific parts of an image, like these ferns. Before I do that, I'll clear the active selection by pressing Command and D on my keyboard. Let's make the Luminosity Mask group visible again so we can see the effect of the curves. If I check each of the curves in turn, we can see that the mid-tone curve highlights the ferns best out of the three. In this example, you can see the ferns are very white, so we probably don't need to make any further changes. But if we did need to better target an adjustment, you would just open the curves dialog and adjust it. By moving these points in towards the center, the selection targets a narrower range of midtones. When you have the mask looking the way you want it, right click on the composite channel and load it. We can then hide the Luminosity Mask group while we work. This time, rather than simply lightening the ferns, I'm also going to apply some color. To do this, I'll sample the orange in the sky so that I can paint with it using the paintbrush tool. Then on my new layer, I'll reduce the opacity to around 70%, and this time I'll set the blending mode to soft light. Now using the paintbrush tool, I can paint over the ferns. This not only lightens the ferns, but it warms them by adding the orange I sampled from the sky. I can also paint over the clouds in the sky, which will help bring out any orange there as well. Now earlier I said that we could adjust our mask to target different areas of the image, and we've already looked at one way of doing this. Another way to refine the Luminosity Mask that you might want to try is to adjust the controls of the black and white layer. By using the color slider, you can change what you target in the image. The only thing to be careful of is creating too sharp a transition between the light and dark areas in the mask. When you don't have a gradual transition through grey, the Luminosity Mask won't produce a natural looking result. Another way to refine your mask is to combine them with the blend ranges control. This video explains how that works and is a good one to watch next. You can even use blend ranges as an alternative to Luminosity Masks. I hope you found this video helpful, and I'd really appreciate it if you share it with other Affinity Photo users. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you soon in another video.